here. I'm live. It is 2 o'clock. So, anyway, let's get started. Sound is okay, or the video is okay, or if anything's messed up, because I don't want it to be. Welcome to my kitchen. Hopefully someday you can come over here in person. We can hang. That was a Sun House song. Here's another one. Thanks, Allison. vegetables, Brenda, are you? I'll probably be doing that later myself. So I don't really know what I'm gonna do today. I had had this plan in mind that I was going to do singer-songwriter stuff. Originally, when I posted the link, I said I might do singer-songwriter stuff, I might do blues, I might juggle. Still don't know. I may juggle. I don't know. So I had a few of my songs that I was going to plan on doing, and I think I'm still gonna do at least one of my songs that I wrote that's not a blues song. And then I had a whole bunch of other songs that I listed in there, all except for one, were John Prine songs. And I'm sure most of you have heard that John Prine got hit by COVID-19 and the coronavirus, and he was in pretty bad shape yesterday. And I just before I came online here, I went and I saw an article. I haven't confirmed this yet, that apparently he's in more stable condition right now, which is pretty good. But anyway, I was rehearsing all those songs. I was going through and rehearsing those songs, and they're on a regular guitar and regular tuning, and you finger the guitar differently, and you know, your hands in different places. And I don't know if any of you know this, or some of you probably do. A little less than 3 years ago, I was cutting chicken, not vegetables, and I chopped off the tip of my finger, just the meat of my pinky, and it took a long time for it to like get to the point where I could be playing like I do when I perform, like what I just did. I think I'm talking fast again. And last night in playing, it got to the point where I couldn't even use my pinky when I was playing a normal guitar, because just the way you hold it and to grab chords, and it was really painful. So I cut the idea of doing all stuff on a normal guitar. So I think maybe I'll stick with just two songs maybe at the end. So, not that these guitars are abnormal, but they're Bob Coyle. Bob Coyle is a friend. I'm going to talk about Bob Coyle. I'm going to tell you secrets, Bob. I've known Bob since I was in fourth grade, and we were very close friends, and this is actually a big reason why I play the music I do. He had an older brother, Steve, who at the time seemed a whole lot older than us. He's probably just 2 years older than us, or a year older than us, but you know, he was his big brother. His brother used to listen to the Allman Brothers Band and Johnny Winter, and Bob and I used to listen to those records, and that got me into hearing the blues stuff. And then I was out with my mom one time. We went to, a few years later, you know, probably in junior high school or so, we went to Leechmere Sales in Dedham, which was a department store, and went to the record section, and I'm flipping through the records, and I see Sonny Boy Williamson, One Way Out, and I knew that name and that song from the Allman Brothers. I brought it home, put it on the record player for Allison, because I know you're young. Records are things that they used to have, these big, round, black things that were bendy, and you put them on a thing that spun and made music. Anyway, I put that on there, and I put on the first song. I don't even remember what the first song, but as soon as I heard it, it was like, I had no idea music like this existed, and it changed my life. And from that point on, it was just like seeking out real blues stuff and trying to listen to it. See here. I have nothing planned out today. The last time I kind of had everything more or less planned out. This time, not. I'm just winging it. What was I going to do? I'm going to do a song I did last time. I think it was a song I ended with. But I'm going to do a different version of it. My pal Eddie Tebby, who, again, I'm going to plug his book. He's got a book out. It just was released And I wish I knew the name of it off the top of my head. Brenda, what's the name of it? He always requests this song. It's a Tampa Red song, and I usually sing it with Elmore James lyrics, but this time I'm going to do the Tampa Red lyrics, which I don't have memorized, so I got them on this little tablet here that you can't see. Mama, for being so blue, when you keep on worrying me the way you do. When things go wrong, so wrong with you, it hurt me too. I'm dogging you the way you do. I may lose my head, mama, my temper too. When things go wrong, so wrong with you, it hurt me too. Your life, mama, right at the start, and if you ain't careful, he'll break your heart. When things go wrong, so wrong with you, it hurt me too. I love you, baby. Put up, mama, with the things you do. When things go wrong, so wrong with you, it hurt me too. Thank you all very much. Hey Bob, I'm glad your wife and daughter heard, hear some blues. Thomas, yes, I have a red crock pot. I can't tell this anymore, but I used to have red hair. Let's see here. Now I've run out of anything I plan to do. What do you want to do, Thomas? Hey, Eddie. World famous author. Come back to
my way, baby. You know I can't get much higher. Well, you're my morning coffee, my evening tea, my all-day study, and my midnight dream. Well, come on home, baby, I'm down on my knees. I said, now come on home, babe, I'm begging, please, 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 you're the one. Show you just how wrong I was. You're the one who really set me aflame. You're the one who really set me aflame. When you look my way, baby, every time you call my coffee, my evening tea. You know I love you, baby, better what I see. Well, come on home, baby, I'm down on my knees. I said, no, come on home, babe, I'm begging, please, 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 you're the one. You really give me a buzz. I can't last much longer. I'll show you just how wrong. How wrong I was.
Okay. Brenda, I want you to stop giving Thomas Walker compliments. He has a big head as it is. Doesn't need to get any bigger. Thomas is my playing partner. Not here though. And he's a tremendous musician. It's a pleasure to play music with him. Plays mandolin, harmonica, guitar. He's top notch at all of them. He's a way better guitar player than I am. So I'm fortunate to have him play with me, to sink down and do stuff with me. Let's see here. What would be a good song to do? This is just like my live gigs, huh? I don't know what I'm gonna do next. And I don't remember what I did in the last show either, so I'll probably just repeat some song. I don't think I did this one. This is, I actually guess, makes sense to do this one. So this is a Robert Johnson song. And then I think I'll switch and do some other stuff other than blues. Come on into my kitchen.
she's gone. No, she won't come back. I took the last nickel of a mission sack. You better come on into my kitchen, because it's going to be raining outdoors. Well, time is coming, and it's gonna be so. You can't make the winner, babe, so drive on slow. You better come on into my kitchen, because it's going to be raining outdoors.
Time here. Yeah, let me switch to do something that those of you who know me and see me perform, you probably never or rarely ever see me use it. So let's see, I gotta stand up and go grab another guitar. Swap this one out with it. I'll be right back. Okay. First, let me tell you about this guitar. The guitar brand is El Benito. Lito Benito was a guitar maker. Lito Benito was one of the guitar luthiers at Taylor Guitars. He's in Chile. And he decided to go back home and start his own guitar company, El Benito. Unfortunately, after he just kind of got up on the road, you know, he produced a fair amount of guitars. He passed away. So there goes El Benito Guitars. Thomas, I can't play my plastic guitar. I should pull it out and show it to y'all. Maybe I will when this is over. That'll be like overtime. So anyway, this particular guitar is the Grand Auditorium model. And this is also a prototype. So this was, you know, one of the early ones they made. They're like very, very, almost a handmade guitar, you know. And so this is a beautiful, beautiful guitar. How it got into my hands was this guitar, my friend Spencer Boren. He was kind of a brand ambassador for El Benito Guitars in the U.S. And Spencer lived right around the corner from me. And I was talking to him one day, and I was telling him that I wanted to get a regular acoustic guitar. But at the time, I didn't have it. I had, you know, I had these kind of weirdo guitars, but I didn't have a regular acoustic. And I told him I was thinking about getting a halfway decent one. A couple of days later, my phone rings, and it's Spencer, and he says, is it okay if Marilyn and I come over for a quick visit? It's like, sure. Spencer and his wife Marilyn, they come in, and Spencer has a guitar case in his hand. He says, here, I want you to have that. It's this guitar. So Spencer Bourne, super sweet guy, I miss him. He passed away recently. And I still have that slide on my finger, if I'd have it. Anyway. Yes, Brenda, they do. I believe that was one of Alex's, or I think Alex was the driver of that, if I remember the story that was told to me correctly. I grew up in Boston, and I lived in a neighborhood of Boston called Rosendale. And on the street was Havana Street, which I always thought was cool because my mother came from Havana. And in the backyard of that house, it was this dead end. It was this dead end. There was a school at the end of the street, which was my grammar school, the Mozart School. The coolest thing about that house, in the backyard there was this big tree, and I spent half my day up in that tree. I climbed that tree all the time. So I wrote this song when I used to write songs. I don't really write them anymore. I wrote this song about hanging out in that tree. And most of it's true. Some of it I made up so that I made the song sound better, but it's pretty much true stuff. And this is probably the only song I ever wrote that it was actually true. Everything else, I write it like I'm writing a novel or something, just making something up and putting myself in someone else's shoes. But this one was kind of really about me. Okay, I should shut up now, huh? And start playing. From the tree in my backyard I can climb up on Mrs. Franklin's garage roof. My mom says I'm not supposed to, but she doesn't always catch me. There used to be a branch hanging. I haven't sung this in a while. There used to be a swing hanging off that big branch over there. One time my sister fell off and she busted her arm. Cecil was a good dog and I miss her. From the tree in my backyard I can see those monsters on the ground, they can only look down. I gotta make my shadow look like a branch, or they'll come up here and get me. One time I climbed up, way, way up, near the top, and my father had to come and get me down. It was kind of scary up there. Cecil was a good dog and I miss her. From the tree in my backyard I can see the other kids on the street. They're older than me but they still let me hang around with them sometimes. I can see over to Kenny's house. I remember when he caught a snake, put it in his garage, but his father found out and he chopped it up with a shovel. Cecil was a good dog and I miss her. From the tree in my backyard I can see my new dog Candy. Cecil was our old dog, but she bit people, now she don't live here no more. to go. You've heard a Mike Pearce original now. Thanks, James. Okay. So I'm gonna do one last song. This is a John Prine song. Hoping he gets better. You were gonna request which one, Brenda? There's a big delay here, so I'm saying this and it's gonna sit here for a while before you actually hear me say it. Okay, Brenda, what are you gonna request? Oops. I clicked on something to get it out of the way. Hey, Maisha. You were gonna request Cecil. Have you heard me do that song before? Anyway, here's a John Prine song to end. This is someone actually told John Prine about the way I performed this song. I've only performed it in public maybe once or twice before. But this guy heard it and he knew John Prine and he told John Prine about it, which is kind of cool. That made me feel good. This is a song about a hot day. Last night it got so hot, I swear, you couldn't hardly breathe. Heat lightning burnt the sky like alcohol. I sat on my porch without my shoes and watched the cars roll by as the headlights raced to the corner of the kitchen wall. Mama dear, your boy is here, far across the sea, waiting for that sacred core that burns inside of me. And I feel the storm all wet and warm, 10 miles away, approaching my Mexican home. God, I cried, it's so hot inside, you could die in the living room. Take the fan from the window, prop the door back with a broom. Well, the cuckoo clock has died of shock, and the windows feel no pain, and the air's as still as a throttle on a funeral train. Mama dear, your boy is here, far across the sea, waiting for that sacred core that burns inside of me. And I feel a storm all wet and warm, not 10 miles away, approaching my Mexican home. Father died on the porch outside an August afternoon. I sipped bourbon and cried with a friend by the light of the moon. Well, it's hurry, hurry, step right up. It's a matter of life or death. Well, the sun is going down and the moon is just holding his breath. Mama dear, your boy is here, far across the sea, waiting for that sacred core that burns inside of me. And I feel the storm all wet and warm, not 10 miles away, approaching my Mexican home. Approaching my Mexican home. Okay. 37 minutes we're at. So let's see what we have here. Brenda says, which Prine song did you sing at Prine Night at Chihuahua? I actually sang three songs. I sang that one. I sang Please Don't Bury Me. And no, I didn't do all, and Maureen. Okay. You know what? Yeah, I'll do Maureen too. John Prine's feeling better. And then this will really be the last song. I just like this song because it's so weird. Maureen, I shot a doctor last night on the airplane. Well, he said he wouldn't hurt us, but he got me all nervous and mean. He was fat and he stank, and God knows he drank more than we do. So I shot him in first class and bailed out and ran home to you. But you don't believe me. I can tell by your smile. Honey, why don't you leave me? Get lost for a while. Maureen, there's a hole in between where we come from. And the things that I'm thinking ain't necessarily things that I say. I may have lied to myself, but I tried to tell God how I love you. But even he don't answer his phone anymore when I pray. But you don't believe me. I can tell by your smile. Honey, why don't you leave me? Get lost for a while. Maureen, I shot a doctor last night on the airplane. Well, he said he wouldn't hurt us, but he got me all nervous and mean. Nervous and mean. Okay, that's really it. Thank you all so much for coming. I really appreciate it. If I do it again, I'll invite you again. Thanks so much. Bye.